This summer, as I do every summer, I visited my great grandmother's house. I was so excited to see her. So when I got to her room, I said cheerfully, "Good morning, how are you?" She looked at me with a puzzled expression and said, "Who are you?" Some of you may have already realized what I'm talking about. Dementia. Yes, my great-grandmother suffers from dementia, and even now as our family members, we always think about how to face this disease. Today, I'd like to talk about dementia, and at the end of my speech, I'll give you a special tip to maintain a good relationship with people suffering from dementia. So first, what is dementia? Dementia is a term that describes a wide range of symptoms associated with a decline in memory or other thinking skills, severe enough to reduce a person's ability to perform everyday activities. What that really means is the symptoms appear slowly but gradually get worse. Common indicators of people with dementia are problems with short-term memory, keeping track of a purse or wallet, paying bills, planning and preparing meals, or remembering appointments. In Japan's aging society, the number of dementia patients will continue to increase. Today, the estimated number of dementia patients aged 65 or older is around 4.5 million. However, according to the government's estimate released in 2015, in just 10 years, the number of dementia patients will be 7 million. This means that 1 in 5 elderly people in Japan will have dementia in the near future. The reality really hits hard when you realize that medically, there is no cure or treatment that slows or stops the symptoms of dementia. When the doctor told me, I was really shocked. I wanted to help, but there is no way for me to help. What's worse, the doctor also told me that my great-grandmother's memory may completely disappear within 3 years. Since I didn't know what I could do, I wasn't able to face reality. I thought if I live with her, I could support her in many ways. But actually, I live far away from her, and it is difficult to restore reality. At one point, I hated myself for being so useless. So I gave up and didn't take any action to help my great-grandmother. However, my mother was different, and finally, she was able to find great success. Here's what happened. One day, my mother told me about a woman whose mother got dementia. That woman was under the same situation as us, but actually, she found a way where she was able to change her mother. Do you know what it was? She sent a postcard every day. Her story was that, at first, her mother hardly ever smiled because she lost the ability, but after the woman started to send a postcard every day, her mother gradually came to smile, and what is more, she came to talk again. Inspired by that story, my mother started to send a postcard to my great-grandmother every day. She wrote simple words on it like, "I ate watermelon today, it was really yummy." Or, "I went to hot spring today, it was so nice, let's go together next time." She also drew a lot of pictures. For example, in summer, she drew a picture of the sea, and in winter, a picture of a snowman. I was so moved by my mother that I began to write postcards with her. Since we started sending postcards, a miracle happened. The next time we visited my great-grandmother's house, she said, "Your postcards are so cute. Thank you." Beyond that, my grandfather told me that my great-grandmother was really looking forward to the postcards every day, and she looked very happy when she received one. Both my you hear that. After 3 years, we realized something incredible. My great-grandmother's doctor originally said that her memory would totally disappear within 3 years. But actually, it didn't. Although she forgot a lot of things, she never forgot us. I felt then, and even now, that it was all thanks to my mother. Where I had given up, she never did. She kept trying her best. Without my mother, I don't believe this miracle would ever have happened. Even now, I don't know whether your postcards were the very reason that slowed down dementia symptoms. But I can confidently say that my great-grandmother's life changed, just like the woman who had sent postcards to her mother. Now, everyone, I'd like you to keep this story in your mind. I believe this story may help you, and also people around you. If your friends don't know how to deal with a dementia person in their family, please tell them this story. That way, no one has to give up hope, even when someone precious gets dementia. 10 years have passed since my great-grandmother was diagnosed as dementia. Over time, she has forgotten almost everything. However, we still continue to send her postcards, because when she sees them, she still sometimes smiles and talks, and hopefully remembers who we are. Every cloud has a silver lining. It isn't always easy to find the good when the situation seems so bad. Once you find it though, life looks a lot lighter. If you or your friends have struggled to find what to do for dementia patients, please tell them this story about sending postcards. I believe postcards will bring happiness for everyone's life. Thank you.
Especially here is that when, if your grandma maybe you sent her to a nursing home and still you want to do something for her. So what do you think is, my question is, what do you think, what is the most important thing to keep a good relationship with your grandma?
Yes, actually, my great-grandmother forgets about me, and even my mother, but I still send her postcards and visit her, because when I talk to her by using postcards, usually my great grandmother have no facial expression and say nothing and always nothing like this. But when I talk to her by using postcards, she still sometimes smiles. So in order to have a good relationship, I want to continue with her and send her postcards forever.
Okay, gotcha. So you keep on doing that.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much.